As we get comfortably seated in Padmasana or Sukhasana, with spine upright, shoulders braced back, eyes gently closed, hands in any comfortable mudra, where the index fingertip touch the thumb tip, the other three fingers are open to face the ceiling, that is the chin mudra rested on the wrists rested on the knees, or any other. With a steady Sukhasana, or for those of us who can sit comfortably in Padmasana, the lotus pose, Padmasana. We try to slowly withdraw our minds now to look at that vast infinite space in front of our closed eyes. To look at colors, shadowy movements, or darkness, or light, or just a ray of white light, acknowledging this Chidakash here. And from this Chidakash, we taper our awareness from vastness to a point at the eyebrow center, the Bhumadhyam. To visualize a candle flame, keeping intensified awareness on this steady candle flame, together we chant the mantra Om now, 3 times. Inhale fully. On finishing the third round of Om chanting, we directly from closed eyes position, open our eyes into looking cockeyed up at the Bhumadhyam, eyebrow center. Sticking the tongue out, we start with Shwan Pranayam. Shwan Pranayam, as the name suggests, means the panting dog breath. Shwan means dog. Where we inhale actively, exhale actively. It's all right to take pauses. And in this same Shwan Pranayama, looking up cockeyed, we turn our heads from right to left and left to right now. Those of us who have been out of practice may get some coughs in this. We may cough a little, or we may want to clear our throats. That's fine. And we restart with Shwan Pranayama. What does Shwan Pranayama do? It helps us master our Kapalbhatis and Bhastrika, which are coming up next. What do Kapalbhati and Bhastrika do? Kapalbhati has innumerable, unginat benefits. Unginat. It's called Rog Anusar Yog, which means to do pranayama and yoga according to Anusar, the rog, the disease that we may be having. What does Bhastrika do? It helps us keep our entire rib cage strong. The lungs, which are embedded in the rib cage, the first lobe, the second lobe, the third lobe, It uses all the way down to the third lobe. Inhale and exhale actively. Almost done. Make sure you inhale actively too. Make sure your eyes are looking up cockeyed. Note that this is Shwan Pranayama, not Kapalbhati. So you have to inhale actively also. Good going. Discontinue Shwan Pranayama. Discontinue. And start with Kapalbhati. What is Kapalbhati? Pulling the abdomen in, we make active exhalations. That's Kapalbhati. Pulling the abdomen in, we make active exhalations. That is Kapalbhati. And let's begin. What are some of the important things that we need to take care of while doing Kapalbhati? We need to make sure that we don't overdo. So don't do more than what your capacity is. Don't ask anyone, I'm doing Kapalbhati every day, how many should I do? I'm doing Kapalbhati every day, what time should I do? You choose your own time. You choose your own pace. You choose your own intensity. You choose your own volume. You choose your own comfort level. All you have to do is active exhalations, pulling the abdomen in. Active exhalations, pulling the abdomen in. It's okay to take pauses and restart. And the next time you take a pause and restart, interlock fingers behind the head so elbows are out like wings. And do the same Kapalbhati exhalations in twists. So your right elbow will go to your left knee. Inhaling passively, you will come back and your left elbow will go to your right knee. Please watch. Make sure you exhale actively when you go down. Your elbow should go towards your alternate knee. Inhale passively when you come back. Your Kapalbhati should not change. Last three sets. Discontinue. With this much, we end with Kapalbhati for today, for now, for this session, and we start with alternate nostril Bhastrika. Alternate nostril Bhastrika. And how will we do Bhastrika? We will increase them in ascending order from 1 to 11. Please watch three sets. 1, 1. 2, 2. Three, three. Notice when I'm exhaling, I'm not exhaling in Kapalbhati. Let's not make that mistake, which means I'm not exhaling. No, I'm doing. Start. 1, 1 to 11, 11. Start. Those who are vertigo conditions, those who are post-COVID conditions, those who have just recovered from any other illness like flu, influenza, may find this a little strong, a little harsh. You can pause at 4-4 or 6-6 or 8-8. But when you restart, restart from the next number. Because you want to reach 11, 11 in an ascending order. Some of us may have one nostril blocked. You get it? For those who are not in regular practice. Ab main regular practice kar rahi hun pranayam ka. Regular. Isliye meri nostril, meri nasika block nahi hai. 90% of the time, meri nasika block nahi rehti hai. Because I am in regular practice. Same must be happening with all those of you who have been in regular practice of pranayam. You will notice just now when you are doing alternate nostril bhastrika from one nostril. Suppose you have reached 9-9. That one nostril may be blocked and the other may be unblocked, open. Or some of us who have regular sinus and other problems, both nostrils are slightly blocked. Or some of us, wow, we are blessed because we are doing pranayam regularly, we'll have both nostrils open. Everything we can handle, no problem. 11, 11 is what we want to reach with both nostrils. Trying to open a blocked nostril or doing with both nostrils open or doing with both nostrils slightly closed. Continue. Almost reaching 11, 11 now. Some of us may have finished the 11, 11. Just do nothing after that. Watch your breath. The other one. Notice how my exhalations don't become Kapalbhati. What are Kapalbhati exhalations? Which are not wrong. It's not a mistake. But we are currently following the practice of Bhastrika. So we want to exhale actively and mindfully too. Is wrong, Kapalbhati. Wrong, Kapalbhati. Right, Bhastrika. Right, Bhastrika. And most of us may have finished the 11-11. At that time, we don't do anything. anything. Nothing like the pleasure of watching the breath. The moment we watch our breath, we are already in the sixth step of Ashtang Yoga. Yam Niyam Asan Pranayam Pratyahar Dharana. What is Dharana? To keep the mind away from scattered thoughts and patterns. Control of the five senses. Sangni Panchendriya. With the mind, we try with the five senses to be controlled. How do we do that? So easy. Kuch nahi karna hai, basically. Hamesha to thak jate hai, kuch kar karke. Isme kuch karna hi nahi hai. Kya karna hai phir? From one breath to the other is life. What proves that we are alive just now? Our breath. What do we do? Watch it. Bas. What do we call this? Meditation. We now do a little quick round, run through of a few pranayams. We start, it will be completely guided. We start with right-handed Nasagraha Mudra where the index fingertip and the middle fingertip touch the thumb joint, the bump near the thumb. And we close our right nostril to inhale and exhale from the left. Chandragan Pranayam. Activates the left nostril, the pingla, the Ida Nadi so well that it opens up blocked nostrils and gives us the intended outcome that we want from an open or a closed nostril. When the mind is super active or disturbed and the right nostril is open, जब मन बहुत चंचल रहता है, डिस्टर्ब रहता है और दाई नासिका खुली होती है, तब हमें बाई नासिका को भी खोलना है और बाई नासिका इस चंद्र अगन से खुलता है, खुलती है. इनहेल, एक्सहेल विद द लेफ्ट नोस्ट्रिल टू कीप द माइंड काम, एट पीस, मेडिटेटिव फॉर प्राणायाम. And from this now convert to inhalation from the left nostril, exhalation from the right. Bai nasika se saas andar le, dai nasika se saas bahar chode. Let's start from sthul to sukshma, matlab gross, intense kare. Aur phir dheere dheere usko gentle karte jaye. Now do more silent, more gentle. Keep going. From sthul, we have moved to sukshma. good going. Inhale from the left, exhale from the right. And in this Chandra Bhedan Pranayam, we now incorporate Chin Law, retention. Inhale from the left, close the left nostril, take a Chin Law. Hold the oxygenated air inside. Drop your head down. Lift it up. Exhale from the right nostril. Same one-way traffic with Chin Law. Inhale from the left. Lock it. Take a Chin Lock. Jalandhar Bandha. Lift the head. Exhale from the right. You will notice in case one nostril is blocked and the other open, it means that we are out of practice. We need to celebrate if both nostrils are open because we have been in regular practice. Chandra Bhedan Pranayama, an excellent and very important pranayama. Try doing it after a few Kapalbhatis and Bhastrikas. Always when doing your own practice. Those who feel heavy in the head or hammering in the head, on the top, on the back, don't do retention. We will get to it slowly and gradually with regular practice. That's why we are not doing retention on the exhalation. We are doing retention only in the holding of the inhalation. We are not doing Bahir Kumbhaka. We are only doing Antar Kumbhaka. Because with regular practice, we moved to that level where we can practice Antar Kumbhaka. Last round. Sukshma. Gently inhale from the left nostril. Close that left nostril with the ring finger tip. Gently, gently, only by touching also it will close. Take a Chin Lock. Drop the head. Lift the head. Lift the thumb. Exhale from the right. It's an inverted V shape and one-way traffic. The left nostril inhales, the right exhales. Discontinue Chandra Bhedan Pranayama. To start with Ujjayi breath, now a very important breath to reverse all fears associated with finances and relationships. I repeat, Ujjayi Pranayama has a lot of other benefits. It clears mucus from the throat. It clears phlegm from the throat. It beautifies our voice for those of us who are singers. Gale mein ghadi ghadi kharash rehti hai when the throat is uncomfortable and we keep clearing it. All that is anyway reversed with Ujjayi. But what is the added benefit with this throat breath? It reverses fears associated with finances and relationships. Inhale fully, exhale completely in the throat breath. Create a friction by contracting the glottis and the epiglottis in such a way that you make a sound, inhaling and exhaling. Those who are complete beginners, or those of you who want to teach Ujjayi to someone who is a beginner, has to open the mouth wide and inhale and exhale. When you open your mouth wide and inhale and exhale, you will know exactly kahan pe contract karna hai. Then dheere, 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 when you open your mouth wide and close it, you will know where you have to contract. That's where the friction has to come. Now close it half. Only for beginners. And inhale. And exhale. Besides clearing the throat, clearing the mucus and phlegm from the throat, beautifying our voice, and the added benefits of reversing, removing fears related to finances and relationships. One more benefit Ujjayi has. It balances the secretions in the throat, and hence, for those of us who have thyroid problems, it balances the thyroid secretions. Prevention is better than cure. And hence, it's one guarantee that one does not have thyroid problems if Ujjayi is practiced regularly. The word Ujjayi comes from the word Ujjapi, which means it is the best, the topmost, the most victorious. In this Ujjayi, let's make our exhalations longer than inhalations now. If while inhaling, we were at a count of 3, let us make our count 5 when we exhale. If while inhaling, we were at a count of 4, let's make our count 6 while exhaling. If while inhaling, we were at a count of 5, let's make our count 7 while exhaling. Ratio 3:5, 4:6, or 5:7. Last round. On finishing this last round, without taking a break, we move to Viloma Pranayama. We have geared ourselves with this today's session after having done those Kapalbhatis and those Bhastrikas and those Ujjayis for Viloma Pranayama. What is Viloma Pranayama? Viloma means exhalation in a reverse order. All right. So we inhale fully. Our lungs are full, and we exhale 1/3, and we pause. We exhale another 1/3, and we pause, and we exhale completely, and we pause. There is one pranayam by the name Anulom Vilom Pranayam. Anulom means two words, Viloma means against. So this is Viloma, which means against, which means out of, which means exhalation. Viloma Pranayama, although it has its own variations. Keep shoulders detensed. For those of you who've been in regular practice and felt very comfortable just doing the Ujjayi before this, can also do Viloma Pranayama in Ujjayi. How do you do that? Inhale in Ujjayi. Exhale 1/3. Another 1/3. Another 1/3. Inhale in Ujjayi. Exhale 1/3. Another 1/3. Exhale completely. Viloma Pranayama in Ujjayi. You've got it. It has no contraindications if your retention is not overdone. No force required. make sure you're behaving like a Munimji, a Metaji, an accountant. Literally, divide that exhalation one third, one third, one third. वो 33 वन थर्ड का भी वो पॉइंट वन थर्ड तक पहुंचना है. दैट 33 वन थर्ड गोज टू मूव ऑन टू अनदर वन थर्ड वेयर ओनली द 0.01% इज लेफ्ट इन द एंड. इनहेलेशंस एंड एक्सहेलेशंस मस्ट बी डन ओनली थ्रू द नॉस्ट्रिल्स. इवन इफ दे आर ब्लॉक्ड मेक एन अटेम्प्ट टू ओपन देम. डू नॉट यूज द माउथ एट ऑल. Only nostrils. On finishing this last round, roll your tongue in all the way back to the small tongue. They call it the small tongue. And the bottom of the tongue is pressed on top on the heart palate. Kechari mudra. In Kechari mudra, do abdominal breathing. Only 7 rounds. Inhale, inflate the abdomen like a balloon. Exhale, bring it back to normal. Abdominal breathing in Kechari mudra. This abdomen has everything. It's called the Manipur. Pur means town. Mani means jewels. And rightly, all jewels are here. From the liver to the spleen to the pancreas to the large and small intestines to the gallbladder to the stomach. And your problems, pressures, and stresses of daily life, we abuse all those organs. We make it tense. Or by eating wrongly, or by eating rightly at the wrong time. And what are we doing just now? Just making sure we correct those mistakes. How beautifully pranayam has solutions to mistakes which we may have made. Abdominal breathing in Kechari mudra. Kechari mudra activates the entire mouth, keeps the tongue extremely functional, and topmost, it is said eventually that Amrit Ras, which falls down from the fontanel, comes there in the small tongue, where the Kechari mudra's tongue tip is ready to receive it, to absorb in the body. This is slightly advanced, of course. It is the ultimate. But just in case we want to know, why are we doing this Kechari mudra? And we release the tongue. We discontinue abdominal breathing for now. But we make sure that we keep a connectivity throughout the rest of the day with Ujjayi. So we keep watching our breath to make sure that we are breathing in Ujjayi breath. That we don't change. From the moment we are born till we breathe our last, we can do Ujjayi. And we've heard the benefits today. We get ready to end this session by keeping the tongue dropped from the heart palate. In case the hands are still in chin mudra, open them. Do a good round of palming. Cap them on closed eyes when the urja is felt. You'll feel it when you rub the warmth. That is the energies, the prana, the urja. Cap them on closed eyes. Open and close your eyes in the darkness of your palm. Stroke the rest of your beautiful face with abundance. And then slowly open your eyes, close them again, and then open them completely. Thank you all. Hari Om Tat Sat.
Thank you.